exciting. It's new, and if you like new technology, it's evolving constantly around you.
Well, if you're interested in maps, or if you're interested in geography, and if you're interested in computers, this is the field for you because it synthesizes those things. We have the biggest GIS program in the country. We have 13 specific GIS courses, starting from introductory courses through intermediate and advanced, and some courses that focus on special technological aspects of the field, such as web-based mapping and intensive database applications.
My boss is thrilled to have me participate in this program and really encouraged me to do so because it just brings all of those capabilities right into our office.
I want to be the GIS specialist, so I want to be the person who's making the databases and helping with the systems that are behind all of it.
The biggest concept is learning the difference between just a flat map on a piece of paper and being able to look at that same geographic area and learn infinite things about it by pulling in data from different sources.
I began as a cartographer, a pen and ink map maker back in the early 90s. And I teach cartographic design, which is map design. I teach spatial analysis and modeling.
Land cover change or change in forest. This is from 84, this is from 91. Looks like we've got more clear cuts over there.
People who graduate from our program work in various levels of government in Sacramento.
Work for a utility company, so we have GSRs and they will go for a field order and we can actually see the GPS in the truck on a map and see where they are going, where they've been. Addresses associated to gas leak orders. So all this stuff is all things that you want to see where this is on a map. And so we're starting to develop heat maps and things so when the customer calls and says, is this something going on in my area, we can actually look at the map and say, yes, it is.
Department of Fish and Wildlife does a lot of work with natural resources. The Forest Service is using it. Economic Development Department uses GIS. It's used in epidemiology. We've got some former students working at UC Davis.
I'm an environmental planner, and we are required to do environmental analysis for a project area. We have to look at biology, we have to look at air quality, we have to look at water, we have to look at traffic and roads and all of these different aspects of this piece of property.
The days are gone when you could build subdivision and just see how it worked out traffic-wise, and now you have to plan for this stuff. And the planning involves the use of GIS to simulate traffic impacts for new developments. And we use the world standard GIS software put out by a company called ESRI. It's called ArcGIS. It includes various applications like ArcMap and ArcCatalog.
The college has the latest version of the software. They're working with the company to get student versions, so we have the software to work with. It's not limited in any way, so we're able to utilize all the extensions and the things that come with it. We're actually very lucky. I've had classes from three different teachers here with all of these different resources. They're all doing different things and they have so much knowledge and so much to add from their own experiences. It's amazing that we have them available to us here.
There's so many great things about the program for a variety of reasons. One, it's the largest in the country, so it's a great resource. Experience teaching. Price is right, so the resources are wonderful and it's so readily available.